Welcome to today's edition of God's Final Jubilee Program. Tune in as your host, Evangelist Dan Goodwin, looks at current events and how they relate to Bible prophecy. It is our sincere prayer that today's program will help you to be ready for the soon return of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Life was filled with guns and war, and all of us got trampled on the floor. I wish we'd all been ready. Children died, the days grew cold. A piece of bread could buy you a bag of gold. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your minds. The sun has come and you've been left behind.
And now, here is Brother Daniel Goodwin with today's broadcast.
This is Dan Goodwin. I'm your host on the God's Final Jubilee program. Welcome to another program here. And you may notice things are a little different around here. We got a brand new studio. And talk about quality, huh? We've got a brand new studio. We got a brand new camera. We got brand new lighting here. And we're taking the program to the next level. And we're going to be on YouTube often. You may be listening today via the YouTube channel. If you're not, and you'd like to, just go on the internet, go to YouTube and look up God's Final Jubilee, and you'll find us. And we'll be posting a program at least once a week, maybe sometimes some mini programs off and on. So be sure and go to the God's Final Jubilee YouTube channel and click the subscribe button. And there's a way to get alerts. You'll figure that out. You're probably smarter with that stuff than I am. But there's a way you can be alerted every time the program is put off up there. And it's possible that you're listening on Facebook. Maybe you saw the YouTube video posted on Facebook. Maybe that's how you found it. And I would invite you to join the Facebook page. We got thousands of folks on there. And growing every day, God's Final Jubilee Facebook page. All that will be shown at the end of the video here. And but we've got a brand new studio. We want to thank the prayer warriors out there. There would not be a God's Final Jubilee program if it were not for God's Final Jubilee listeners out there and folks that follow us. And there's many of you that have prayed for us. Many of you tell me that you pray for us. And several of you have given financially, either on a monthly basis or a one-time gift. And I want to tell you, we couldn't do it without you. We wouldn't be on the air here without your help. We wouldn't have this camera, wouldn't have this studio. And so especially want to thank Dan and Rhonda. I know they don't want me to mention their names, and to God be the glory, but they gave us a great amount of money to help us get the studio equipment here. Very thankful that we're going to we got the same message. The book, we're going to preach the book. We're going to tell you what God said. But now we can look a little better and sound a little better while we do it. Something else exciting I want to share with you. We are now on the Holy Spirit Broadcasting Network. In fact, this is our first program to be aired on the Holy Spirit Broadcasting Network. And so we got the studio here. And so if you're interested in finding that, maybe you're watching on the Holy Spirit Broadcasting Network. If you are, we'd love to hear from you. Send me an email, daniel@godsfinaljubilee.com. That'll show on the screen later as well. daniel@godsfinaljubilee.com. I'd like to hear from you, and I'd like to know where you're listening. I'd like to know if you're listening on the Holy Spirit Broadcasting Network or Roku, or whether you found us on YouTube. I'd love to hear from you. We'd like to know that you're out there. And this is our first time on the Holy Spirit Broadcasting Network. So if you're listening on via the Holy Spirit Broadcasting Network, we'd like to wish you welcome. And we are a program that deals with prophetic events. And I've written a book called God's Final Jubilee. It's been an absolute bestseller on the internet. And I give God the glory for that. My name's on it, but I'll tell you what, I sat down at my kitchen table and God gave me some things. I'm not spooky. I'm not saying that I heard voices, but I'm telling you, I studied. I believe God gave me some things, and I put them in this book, and I believe these are things that we need to know about today. God's Final Jubilee. I'll be honest, for years I didn't know what a Jubilee was. I couldn't have spoke 2 minutes on the Jubilee. Let me read what it says on the back cover, because we're going to talk about some of these things at the end of the program today. So, is God's 70th and final Jubilee on the near horizon? Are we the last generation? Is the return of the Lord sooner than people think? Is the clock getting ready to strike midnight? Is the trumpet getting ready to sound? This book is being proclaimed by some as the most up-to-date study of prophetic events of our day. Others have called it a stunning and even chilling revelation of how close we are to the end of the world. The author believes, that's me, the author believes that Jesus is getting ready to fulfill the final Jubilee and reclaim planet Earth. Here we are at the end of all things. Everything on Earth is about to change. Apart from the Bible, this may be the most important book of our time. It's time to awaken to the reality that we may be the final generation. We may be the generation that's caught up to meet the Lord, and it may be sooner than anybody thinks. So that's the book. If you have not read that book, I would highly recommend to go to the website, godsfinaljubilee.com, and get you a copy, or at least read the back cover and look it over, see if it's something that that catches your eye and your fancy. And I would suggest you go take a look and possibly get a copy. And if you're an Amazon person, the book is available on Amazon in paperback and in Kindle. If you're an ebook reader, you can have it instantaneous. But we'd love to be a blessing to you. Love to get the word of these books into your hands. My newest book is called The Barley Harvest. You see it right there. And we'll talk about that on another program a little bit. But very important book. Very important book. Some very stunning new developments in there that I believe the Lord gave me. So you're seeing the new studio here. We're very excited about it. Very excited about the quality being better. Same old message, but now a better quality message. And so tell your friends about the program. We deal with prophetic things. We deal with the coming of the Lord. We talk about the rapture. We talk about the second coming. We talk about what's going to happen during the tribulation period, who the two witnesses are, all things like that, biblical things, prophetic things, Daniel's 70th week. And so if those things are of interest to you, this is a good program for you to watch each week. And we'd like to help you with that. So tell your friends about it. If you're on Facebook, share it on Facebook with your friends. If you got neighbors or at your church, tell your church folk. godsfinaljubilee.com. That's the website. Everything can be found right from the website. The Facebook page is on the website. The YouTube channel can be got right from the website. Now there's something else going on. This in just 4 weeks away, well, depending on when you're seeing this, October the 15th, I'm hosting a prophecy conference in Mankato, Minnesota. And if you're anywhere nearby, if you're within a 6 or 8 hour drive, you need to come. You really do. I've got two other guest speakers coming. I've got myself. We'll each be speaking two times. The conference starts at 2 p.m. on Saturday, October the 15th. This is all on the website, God's Final Jubilee. Everything's there, directions, times, who the speakers are, where it's going to take place, hotel information, food, all that's on the website. But we got three speakers, myself included. We're going to speak two times each on Saturday, October the 15th, and starting at 2 p.m. And guess how much it cost? Zero. It is free. We may not be able to do that every time. This is our third conference out there. Every one of them so far has been free. Now you got to get there, you got to get your hotel, you got and whatnot. But the conference is free, but you do need to register because seating is limited, and to be honest, it's filling up. And so I would get on the website and I'd get signed up for that as soon as I can. As soon as the website opens up, right there on the left corner there, you'll see the big poster. Just click on that and you can register, free of charge to register. So make sure you do that. And starts at 2 p.m. on Saturday, and it's going to go till 9 p.m. And guess what? Not only is the conference free, but we're going to feed you while you're there. At 6 p.m., we're going to take a break from 6 to 7. You don't even have to leave the conference grounds. We are going to have food for you right there on the premises. And you'll get to eat with us, you'll get to speak with us, you'll get to fellowship, and it's going to be a great time. So we're going to speak two times each. And my other guests are Dr. Kevin Clarkson, the host of Prophecy in the News TV. And many of you have seen Prophecy in the News. I'd highly recommend their ministry, and I'd highly recommend you check out their website, prophecynews.com, I believe it is. And Dr. Kevin Clarkson's the host. I've been interviewed on his program, dozens of times, but I love their program. And Dr. Kevin Clarkson's a wonderful man, a wonderful guy, knows his Bible, loves prophecy, loves the Lord Jesus, and he's going to speak twice for us. I'm excited about that, and you'll love getting to meet Dr. Kevin Clarkson. We've also got Pastor Billy Crone from Las Vegas, Nevada. He is the head of the ministry called Get a Life Ministries. Many of you know him. He speaks at a lot of the conferences around the country. I've been with him at several conferences. I've been with him at the Prophecy and News Conference. I've spoke with him at the Southwest Radio Church Prophecy Conference. I've been there with him. And but he gets around a lot. He does a lot of DVDs. And by the way, I want to thank him and his ministry. They helped my ministry. They helped us understand what camera to buy and lighting. And we owe a debt to his ministry for his help. He's got a cameraman. He's got a guy that works with him named Reed. I'll give a shout out to him. Thank you, Reed, for your expertise and your help trying to teach this greenhorn how to operate a camera. And I ain't there yet. I'm still growing, but and you'll see the ministry, you'll see the stage, you'll see the studio change over time, but we're just getting going here. But I want to thank them. But Billy Crone will be with us. He's a great guy, and he's going to be speaking twice also at the conference. So, by the way, if you come early, if you're there on Friday, guess what? We're going to feed you again. If you're there in time Friday, from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. on Friday night in Mankato, Minnesota, we are going to Jake's Pizza, and we're going to feed you. You get to come free of charge. We're not sure how many are going to come. And again, you're going to have to register, and you're going to have to call the number on the website, Neil Koss, and let him know you're coming Friday, because the seating is very limited there. So, but it's free of charge. We're going to Jake's Pizza, the best pizza you'll ever eat, Jake's Pizza in Mankato. And we're going to have a time of fellowship. And by the way, all three of us speakers will be there. Myself, Dr. Clarkson, Billy Crone, we'll all be there with you. We're not sure what we're going to do yet. We may take some questions. We may just give a 5-minute lecture. So I don't know yet, but you'll be glad you're there. You'll get to rub shoulders with us. You'll get to talk to Brother Clarkson. You get to take pictures with him and all that kind of stuff. Get him to sign your Bible, whatever you want. But what an opportunity. My goodness. If you are anywhere near Mankato, Minnesota, you ought to come to this thing. Listen, my friend, we're at the end of this thing. We're at the end of time. We're at the end of this age, and the Lord's coming back. And later on in some other programs and on my Facebook page, I'll be sharing the topics that each speaker will be talking about. I've already got them, but I'm not going to give them to you today. But I've got all the messages, titles of all three of us, all six messages. And many folks have asked if it's going to be live streamed. I do not think so. That could change, but I doubt it. At this time, we are not set up for live stream. However, I believe I'm going to be videoing the whole thing, or at least some of it. But we'll let you know at the conference how you can participate in getting a DVD or something of the whole conference or whatever. But we're still working on some of those odds and ends there. But get there if you can. If you're close enough to drive, come. If you want to fly in, we're only 1 hour from the St. Paul, Minneapolis airport. And the hotel is just an hour away. The conference is just an hour away. We're going to feed you twice if you come Friday. You're going to get to rub shoulders with everybody. We're going to have a wonderful time. You're going to hear some great speaking. I know Billy Crone does PowerPoint. I'll be doing PowerPoint for both of my messages, and I promise you, you're gonna be glad you were there. You're gonna be glad you saw what you're gonna see. So that's what's going on there. I almost forgot the young lady that sings on my program. You heard her at the introduction to my program. I wish we'd all been ready. Megan Hauser is the young lady that sings. She is going to be at the conference, and she'll be singing at least three times, maybe even four or five times. It just depends how it goes. She's going to be singing that song. She'll be singing the Revelation song. And after that, I don't know. But those are two songs that I've demanded, that I've requested that she sing. And I'm bringing her in, so I guess she's got to do what I say. Amen. And her dad's coming, Phil Hauser. And I want you to meet. I want you to meet him. By the way, he'll be running security. We will have security in the building. And Phil Hauser will be in charge of that. He's a tremendous guy, a good friend of mine. And I want you to meet him. Him and his daughter will be singing with us. And you'll hear her again at the end of the program. She comes on, and she'll have her CD there. You can meet her. You can get her. You can get a CD and maybe have her sign it or something. You know, whatever. But get to meet her. Listen, it's going to be wonderful. It's going to be a great time. You're listening to God's Final Jubilee program. You can find me at godsfinaljubilee.com. You can find me on Facebook, God's Final Jubilee, or the YouTube channel, God's Final Jubilee YouTube. And love to hear from you, Daniel@godsfinaljubilee.com. Let me read a scripture for you. As I said, this is a program where we discuss prophetic events. We discuss things going on in the news. And my goodness, this is the 18th, I believe, 18th or 19th. I've lost track. This is Sunday. I think it's the 18th of September. And overnight, at least two major events happened. Up in St. Paul, Minnesota, there was eight people stabbed by some ISIS guy, Muslim, and in New York City there was an explosion and terrorism, and they found two or three other devices that didn't go off, and there's stuff going on around the country. You better wake up. And bad stuff. I tell people all the time, bad stuff is coming to America. It's already here, but I mean, you ain't seen nothing yet. You ain't seen nothing yet, I'm telling you. I've said for 2 years now that I don't believe there'll be an election. And somebody called me just recently and said, Brother Goodwin, do you still believe that there's not going to be an election? Have you changed your mind? I said, oh, no, I feel stronger about it than I did. And, you know, there's a lot at stake, more at stake than you realize. Now, I mean, there's tyranny and treason been committed in our government. From Hillary to the president to the defense, guns being sold to Mexico and guns to Benghazi. Over that was gun running in Benghazi. There's been tremendous tyranny and treason committed, and my goodness, can you imagine if the wrong person gets to the presidency and begins an investigation? People are going to jail. So there's a lot at stake, and they're not just going to walk away. And you mark my words there. And something's coming. It's going to bring martial law. Look at my newsletter. I have a newsletter I send out, God's Final Jubilee newsletter. And if you go to my website, the box pops up. Put your email in there, and I send out an email every week, and I put several news stories about what I'm talking about. And all the people talking about if one of the candidates should die, it would postpone the election. You see, they're preparing us, aren't they? They're preparing our mind to accept something that's coming. And then there were two or three other stories that I posted in the newsletter, just unbelievable. I mean, they're almost telling us, hey, guess what? There's not going to be an election, and here's why. And, I mean, they're preparing our minds for it. They're already setting it out there saying, look, the president has a right to do this. If something happens, he's obligated to do this. And now you just realize, I know what I'm talking about. So, look, be prayed up. Be walking with God. And we're at the end of this thing. Don't be caught not ready when the trumpet sounds. Let me read you a verse. 2 Timothy chapter 3. Verse 1, this know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. Did you notice the wording there? In the last days. When's the last days? Well, some people say, well, we've been in the last days for 2,000 years. That's right. I agree. Hebrews chapter 1 tells us that. We've been in the last days since Jesus Christ showed up. But you know what? There's also what the Bible calls the last of the last days. Look what it says here. This know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. Is that past, present, or future? That's future, isn't it? Paul, in the last days when Jesus showed up, is saying that in the last days, at the end of this thing, perilous times shall come. He's talking about a future event, isn't he? Look what he says here about these last days. Here's what he says in the last, what I call the last of the last days, at the end of this thing, right before the coming of the Lord. Here's what the Bible says is going to be going on. For men shall be lovers of their own selves. Now, doesn't that sound like the world today? You say, well, it's always been that way. No, sir, it hasn't always been that way. It hasn't always been to the degree that it is now. Men shall be lovers of their own selves. It's all about us, isn't it? And you just listen to people. Listen to the Hollywood people. Listen to the politicians. Listen to your average person. It's all about us, isn't it? Men shall be lovers of their own selves. What else? Covetous. People are covetous today, aren't they? Boasters. Proud. Blasphemers. Disobedient to parents. Unthankful. We're the most unthankful generation in the history of the world. The country that has more than any country's ever had in the history of the world is the most unthankful country in the history of the world. That's the truth. Unthankful, unholy. Just look at Facebook if you don't think we're unholy. My goodness, just look at some of your Facebook friends. Look at some of the people who claim to be Christians. I'm not saying they're not Christians. Look at Christians. Look at what Christians say. In one post, they'll talk about how good God is and how I love God and I pray and all that. The very next post, there'll be some immoral thing or some lewd picture or some dirty joke or they'll use vulgar language. We're unholy today. My friend, we're unholy. This is talking about us. This is us. We're the last generation. We're the final generation upon the world. Look what it says here in verse 3 about this final generation. In the last days, perilous times shall come. And he explains what's coming in that last perilous generation. And I'm reading some of that to you now. Look what he says in verse 3. That last final generation will be without natural affection. Without natural affection. What is he talking about there? Let me just be very blunt here, my friend. There is nothing natural about a woman murdering her unborn baby in the womb. There's nothing natural about that. Nothing. It's wicked. It's evil to take and destroy your little baby in the womb. For whatever reason you think it is. Without natural affection. You can't have natural affection and walk into an abortion place and murder that little baby. Like it's happening every day in our country. Little babies being butchered and murdered. There's nothing natural. That's not a natural affection. Women used to have a natural affection for the children. And I'm seeing that more and more as the older I get, the more I'm seeing women who have no affection for their children. Very strange, isn't it? We're in that last day. But there's another thing about this natural affection. Let me be very, very blunt again, because the Bible's very blunt about it. This isn't what I believe. This is what God says. There's nothing natural about two men getting married. There's nothing natural. There's no holy matrimony there. That's an unholy union. Nothing natural about that. Now, you can say what you want. God, you don't have to listen to my program. That's up to you. I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm going to tell you what the Bible says. It's an abomination to God. Nobody is born a homosexual, a sodomite. And nobody's born that way. And what's going on in our country today is not natural. Not natural. You never would have thought, 20 years ago, my friend, you never would have thought you'd see the day that two men would publicly get married. Would you have ever saw the day when you could get sued for not baking a cake for a gay wedding? Would you have ever dreamed in your wildest imagination that these things could happen? And yet they are. These are just some of the attributes of the final generation. That we read about in 2 Timothy chapter 3. In the last days, perilous. By the way, that word peril, perilous, it means dangerous. These are dangerous days. Listen, when men are lovers of their own selves, that's dangerous. You see that out on the highway, by the way, when people are trying to get somewhere, your life doesn't matter. They'll cut you off on the highway. They'll speed by you. They'll if you're broke down the side of the highway, they'll fly by 80 miles an hour, 6 inches from your door. Why is that? Because men are lovers of their own selves. I've got to get somewhere. Don't get in my way. your life's of no value to people anymore. That's a dangerous age to live in. That's where we're living, my friend. And a whole list of things here, we read some of them. Without natural affection, that's dangerous. Hey, you don't think that's dangerous? I promise you, that little baby in the womb, when people have no natural affection, that's very dangerous. Do you know the most dangerous place to be in the world? Two of the most dangerous places in the world, a public school classroom and the womb of a mother. A lot of bad things happen there. How sad that is. A whole list of things here. Truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. My friend, we're living in perilous times. We are living in the final generation. I believe that. We're living in a dangerous time. Hey, but we're living in an exciting time. We're the generation that's going to go up in the rapture. I'm convinced of that. We're the generation that is going to hear the trumpet sound. We're going to be caught up, and we're going to be with the Lord. Be ready for him, my friend. Listen, don't let that trumpet sound and you not be ready for it. Don't let the trump of God sound and you get caught up and you meet Jesus face to face and be embarrassed and be shocked. Don't let that happen to you. Make sure that you're ready to meet the Lord. God bless you, my friend.
You have been listening to God's Final Jubilee broadcast with evangelist and best-selling author Dan Goodwin.
The Father spoke, the demons died. How could you have been so blind? There's no time to change your mind. The sun has come and you've been left behind. And there's no time to change your mind. Oh.